Hey, Don here. Make sure everything is up and ready. Okay, so this is how I'm going to hang the bottom of my grill. Let's see, is that not sitting there? Oh. It's wrong. That's the top. The rounded part is on the bottom. That's how I come on. I was thinking, you know, when I was looking at where the screws came from and everything, or where I thought they came from, I was thinking that the rounded was on the top, but that's the opposite. So see, I was just fixing to do it wrong. Okay, so I need to turn this around. Glad I noticed that. Oh, yeah, that one's broke. Could put some glue on it, but I guess that could be done while it's in the truck if I really wanted to do it. So yeah, I thought I had it all set up for a good shot, but I didn't. Okay, there we go. That's what you're doing. So, about as good as I'm going to get it. I'm going to put this picture hanger, or wall anchor, in there. And what you got to do when you want to use them like this, I've done it in the house before, take them all the way off. Like, well, when I hung my TV mount, I didn't have a stud in one or two other places, so I did that, put it on there, and then shove it through the hole. And I can't remember. Oh, I had to. I don't know. It was even more tricky than what I'm going to do now. Luckily, these are slots, not holes. So I just slide them sideways and then get them somewhere where they'll hang. And I was going to get my cordless out. Let's see if it'll work at all. I tried to charge it earlier because it's been working for at least 10 minutes. Not very powerful, but it was working. But okay, I think maybe it'll dry, do what I want to do with this. Let me get the chuck for it. I got a quick change that I can put on it. Let's see, which one do I want? Everything always falls out of their places. I don't need the one to hold the drill, so I'll use this little short one. It was blinking really fast, and I thought it surely didn't have enough time to charge, so I thought it wasn't going to charge, and I took it out. When it's blinking fast, that means it was an error. Anyway, oh yeah. The only thing about this thing is it's backwards. You pull it out to open it, and then pull it back to close it, and that's backwards to me. So I'm always trying to remind myself how to operate it. It's pretty cool though, I can do a lot with that. Oops. But now that those won't stay in there when you shut the lid, that part's pretty cool. Oh, well, if you put it the other way, it will for a little. At least until you shut the lid. Okay, now that'll let me drive these really long screws in without twisting my fingers for an hour and a half. When you spoil with fancy tools, you spoil with fancy tools. That's how it is. Moving stuff around, this is actually my table saw table here. And so there's stuff. I keep cardboard on it to keep from messing it up. But so anyway, that will, twist just like they do on the wall. But I'll be able to see. Let's take a screwdriver in there and put it where I want it. So let's just do the other one. Because if I start and stop 100 times, then it's not, it's even worse, I think. So where is it? There you go. Can't get a really good view of it, but well, this one's brand new in the package. The other one's brand new, it's just not in the package. They come with a little screw and one of these other kind of anchors. I don't know where they came from. They kind of makes you think they came with a product or something. I don't know. I've never really seen them come like that. You know, like when you just go to buy some, they usually see if that would get a hold of anything. You could use that. That wouldn't last as long as that Chevy plastic, though. That General Motors plastic. I did find some more screws, and I forgot to pick them up and bring them over here. Let's get this on here first. And the rest of them I'll use the plastic inserts that are already in there and that haven't broke. I need to just find the... Actually, I thought of some ways, you know, well, you could make a... If you took a piece of something like, cedar, I do have some cedar wood. Cedar lasts a long, long time. And you were to dado some little slots in just the width of the blade that would fit in those slots up there that I showed a while ago. And then just take your, you could even get one of those self-tapping screws that's not even for wood, like the kind that has a drill bit on the end, and then drive that in there. I have some of those that would actually just fit, but they're just a little big for these plastic anchor things that I have here. Oh, I lost the one I had. I'll go get those screws. Let's just go get them. That's enough of that shot. Okay, we'll go get the screws together. Okay, oh, there it is. I found these that are non-magnetic, so they're brass. They're the right size, but I think that unthreaded portion won't quite work. I don't think it will. Be nice to have some that don't rust, but I did find three, and those are some machine screws that I wanted to put in a different bucket of screws. Okay, but I have found one, two. These are for really. Well, these are off of probably this truck. I'm not sure, or maybe that van. They're typical of like, well, outside and inside of them, like trim screws and stuff. So that's what this is. This is a little bit smaller thread anyway. Yeah. I'm not going to try with that. That's not of any use to me anymore, but I'm going to put it over here. Not for this anyway. It might work for something else. That I'll put back with all my other stuff like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I actually only need 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. Okay, I had found one, and I thought, I'm not going to find any for all that, but I did. Let's try, make sure they're going to fit. Put one. I haven't put one in the deal yet, in the plastic deal. It's the right size and everything, so. Yeah, they're kind of rusty too. I don't know if I'm even getting any, this is not much improvement, I don't think. They still have some chrome on the outside. Let's see if it really looks like there's any difference worth getting these all rusty. I mean, well, it doesn't matter. Yeah, these could be tail light screws. Or that one's a little smaller. That's the one that I'm pretty sure is a hinge screw for a cabinet, house cabinet. That one. That one. And that one. I must have just put them all in there. They do last a long time. They stand up in the bathroom with all the moisture for years. 15 years plus. They'll get rusty, but they don't break off. I thought they were, they're not brass. They're harder than brass, but they must be coated in some way. They're probably a different kind of alloy that they stand up, because the coating, you know, the coating would just come off too quick if it was just a coating. But let's get this camera all around here. Okay, there we go. Now, right there, and that'll be good. It's just gonna get. does. Kind of got me hung up. I've got them in place on the bottom, but it actually needs to go in the top first. But then I could never get those on the other. Well, because I was able to move it back and forth a lot, getting that bottom in. Let's try, it's so close, let's try a little rubber hammer. I don't want to hit, that's something a little big. I don't want to hit it with something big. I noticed that top one's actually cracked a little bit. Down there, it won't stay. Okay, let's start with our screws on the top. A lot. Give my light to see if my little hair from the bottom is still in place. I think I have to put the first screw in. Looking at the old ones, see if they're any longer. No, they're no longer than new ones. Just a little bit loose so that if I need to jiggle it around a little bit, I can. drill and see if I can get it out. What I do with it. That one's gonna have to go in the garbage. Stripped. Doesn't really feel stripped when you turn it on its own. I won't throw it away yet. Thing fell out of there. My little grabber. See it on the ground. Sure. Here's the ones that are still working. They're rounded on one side and flat on the other. But it did come out and it was sliding. Well, they're supposed to slide so you can adjust them. Oh, I see. So that broken one used to look like that. See? It's broken off a lot more than I realized. So yeah, there's no way it's gonna work. Okay. Let me get a drink. Now, will my nimble little fingers go up in there and put that in there? That's the thing we want to know now. Take those screws loose. I'm gonna end up breaking the glue. I won't use the drill again. The magnet pulls them out now. Come on out where I think maybe I can get another foot. That didn't make any sense. Thank you. came out because it's loose like that because this broke too. It's supposed to have two round things on it, evidently. So it just flops. I'm gonna have to try another one of those. Move that one without thinking. Okay, now those others in the center I'm not gonna throw. What I'm gonna do though is get me another one of those hangers. I was thinking about it would be, you know, the strength needed would be more at the top than anywhere. But also don't want to make it so hard to get off. It ever needs to come off of you. But I don't want it rattling either. It's coming loose. So actually I could do both corners maybe. Let's just do this left one and then we'll see how it can do that. Yeah, here's a good one. But you know what? I think I'm going to go ahead and put one of those up there. Well, I don't know. I mean, if they rust in place, I'd be sorry having that video been there. I'm gonna do it because this is really old plastic. Prime for breaking. And I don't know. I can't actually think right now what. It doesn't seem like it would be that bad getting them out because I can, you know. If this would, I've done it, I've had it happen before, this would break off of this little nut up in there, and then that little nut will pull through out of that slot easy. And the length of them, unless they're too long, I haven't tightened any of them up yet, the length of them makes me able to get it in there. If it wasn't exact, if it was a quarter inch shorter, I probably couldn't get it in there. Thing to do is put the middle screws in and then the rest, you know, they have a lot of leeway. bring the camera over there and show you what it is I'm doing. It's probably not all that self-evident, I'm thinking, as to what I'm actually doing here. At least not to everybody. Okay, so okay, there's that one. If I can show it. Okay, it's right up in there. And see that when you turn them, they're just going to do like they do in the wall. Well, of course, they grab the sheetrock in the wall, but in here they got a sidewall to grab. So, and it's a slot, not a hole. So as long as you get them in there, a little tricky, but they should. I can shove it on up and screw in those middle holes and still be okay, I think. I don't know if I can show those. Yeah, there's one. Let's go to the other one. Got all kinds of cords tangled up here. Now this one I may not be able to get to. Show it, but anyway, there's two out of three ain't bad. You can't see it from that side, and I can't get there because of you. Okay, so, and then there's a screw down here, there's this one up here, and another one down in the bottom that you can't see right now because, well, it's not actually in its right place. So that's the screw that I think I will throw away. I'm pretty sure it was stripped. I'm bad about saving. I'm thinking, oh, I might need that exact size and be desperate. You know, you can't put them on and thinking you're never going to take them back out, but you always are going to take them back out at some point. So trying to get just the grill in there. Okay, now, I don't know, the camera's too close to the edge of the table. What happened? It doesn't want to move side to side, but it moves too easy up and down. Okay, there we go. Now, I know I get in the way, but I can't really set it much of any better place than that. Have a drink right quick. It was 94 a while ago. It's 93 now and it's 5:30. It's the latest I've worked since I've been doing all this. At least it's not 90. It was 94 something earlier, so I guess it's cooling off already. That's good. Screws are even as good as the ones I'm taking out, but they look more rusty, so I'll go with these. Yep, that was actually easy. Fourth time around. ones have plenty of room, but the bottom ones are bottoming out. So that means I would have to either put a big long spacer on the outside or cut those off. Cut them off. Either way, I have to take them off and put them back on. You have to make sure that they're not doing that on you. Actually spinning on me. That one's working perfectly. I guess I need to put a screwdriver in there and kind of overscrew. But what I'm wondering about, I don't think I still thought about tying those up and then work with those, but I might have to take it all loose again. So I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do about the bottom of it. I'm either gonna have to fix them and leave them out. Because it will never, it's actually would spin and tighten up real good, but it won't tighten up. It never would tighten up. It should just be there. And I don't think I could thread them on. Pretty tricky to get lined up and get them threaded on. Cut it off and then kind of polish it so that it would thread easily and cut, you know, ground it off and everything. Let's see. Tape. And that's the only thing I can see. I've got little bitty rulers and stuff in my machinist rulers, but I can't see the marks on them anymore. And my dial calipers, the whole deck gauge broke off of it. Okay, so. Actually, instead of, well, it doesn't matter. Whichever, if I use one, then I need to just go by it. I'm fine. One of them will measure in 64ths or something. This one's in thousandths, which is, for this kind of thing, that's better anyway. If I can just see it. H300 is what it looks like. So, this one I can kind of get to, so I'm going to try doing it. Take it off and then try to see if I can put it back. If I can't, I could use that one plastic deal. The other side, I don't know. I mean, they were hanging free before and it had to fill off, but I wonder. See, I have to kind of problem is, if you haven't ever worked with these things, where's the camera? This little nut swivels. A nut that you put it into. That's it's in it. See, I'll screw it in a little bit. See, it swivels that far. Pretty hard to get it to line up. So, give me a marker. I'm gonna say inch 300. I mean, I don't want to have to cut it over and over. That's a lot. Go any shorter than too short and mess things up either. But right there where my thumb is how much of it I need to cut off to get it to fit in there and screw all the way down. So guess the best thing, easiest way to do that is with my grinder. It's got a wide blade in it. I've got one that's really good for grinding, not so much for cutting off. Could use a hacksaw, but you can't really hacksaw anything without a vise. I've got one way up there in the hot part of the garage, but I can't hardly get to it either. So, and I don't want to mess up my wire cutters and stuff. So, let me move this measuring stuff. Put it back here behind the camera for now. Okay, now. It would cut it though, my big old cable cutters, but I don't want to use that. Okay. Actually, the quickest thing I can get to is my handsaw that has a metal cutting blade on it. Doesn't have a metal cutting blade in it right now. It has a diamond tile cutting blade in it. The last thing I want to use is the quickest thing to get to. I guess that's alright. I just put that right up there to where I want to cut at. And do it like that. Being lazy. But it is hard to hold in place too. I wasn't just making all that up. Any kind of a workbench is better than nothing. I'm leaving it on the bench so that it won't. Now let's. I think it'll hold it good enough. So when I get down to the end, it's gonna give me trouble getting all the way through it. Pretty darn easy, wasn't it? They're pretty soft stuff, that stuff is. Okay, now it's got to be... Round it off a bit. Not too tight, I don't want to mess it up. It's already hot as blazes. Definitely don't want to mess up that part of the throw. Let's hold it by the... Let's hold it by the head this time. That way we won't take a chance on the threads getting messed up. Hold it straight. Yeah, that'll do. Now, electric drill and everything is up there in that cabinet behind my little baby sawhorses and my grinder and all that. Guess I'll have to get something out. Oh, I've got my cordless. I mean, it doesn't need much. I'd rather use my little sanding pad that's in my drill, my electric drill set, but really one of these will do. Maybe if it'll grind long enough, if that drill will work long enough. I'm just planning on using it for the, since it doesn't have much juice. Plan on just using it for the, screwdriver part. Actually, I could probably do it by hand if I need to. Good enough. Might do it. Let's see. I'd have to be able to do two of them, but oh yeah. Good job. Good job, boy. Okay. Now, let's see if I can get that in there. Let's see if I can get it in there. Okay, we'll try. If I can get that one back in there and the other one, that'd be really nice. Thank you. touch the back of that hole and I actually drop the spoon. I'll go all the way down and see if it's going to tighten up without bothering me out, and then I know I'm in there. Actually, if I get my hand in there like that, I can hold it in the right place. Heat off my face for a second. Get in front of the fan. I guess I could move the fan up this way, but it would just be in the way so much. But if I don't keep it back there in the garage, then, well, for one thing, it's loud in the mic of the camera, but the other thing is it's really hotter right there than anywhere, so in the garage. So I want to get in there digging for stuff. Okay, I'll have to do that again, I guess. Let's see if I can do the same thing successfully again. Actually, I don't need to move that, do I? Before I took it off, that was a lot of trouble.